Hey guys, what's up? It's Laughing, and today I'm going to be going through my Aimlab settings and explaining how and why I choose the setting options I do. This will help make the application easier to use and run smoother, making your overall Aimlab experience better. I will be covering crosshair, audio, graphics, visuals, controls, game, and keybinding settings, and there will be chapters so you can watch through or skip to what you're curious about. Really quick, before continuing, only 5% of you are subscribed, so if you enjoy my videos and want to see more, don't forget to subscribe and also drop a like. Now back to the video. You can navigate to your settings from any tab in the main lobby screen by finding the settings in the bottom right of your screen. If you are mid-task, you can also adjust your settings here, just hit escape and then click options and you'll be in the settings menu. First, we will look at crosshairs. I use a simple small black plus, but you may use whatever design works best for you. Before we move on, I will share some general tips and recommendations. Choose a color that contrasts both the background and any target color possible. For me, that means I avoid light gray from the background and teal, red, and dark blue, as these are my target miss and hit colors, which are options you can change, but we will get to that a bit later in the video. Audio is personal preference as well, but I play with everything set to zero except my master volume, as this gives me general sound but no music or hits. This makes it silent on the menu screens and during tasks, but I get sound while scrolling options and settings and when tasks end. Now on to graphics. Here is your opportunity to make your game run smoother. I will run through the options from top to bottom. Display mode, I use full screen exclusive. This is the best option unless you want to tab out of Aimlab as you play, and if that is the case, opt for full screen windowed. For display, select the monitor you want. This is really only important if you have more than one monitor. Display resolution, you should select the highest resolution. I turn display stretching ratio off, but if you use a non-standard aspect ratio and feel the game looks not quite right, try turning it on. Your max queued frames should be set at 1 low latency for the least delay time and best results. If you feel your frames sometimes stutter, turn frame rate limiter on. This will keep your frame rate consistent. Your max frame rate should be at or just above your display max frame rate. There's no reason to go any higher, and if your computer cannot handle your monitor's max frames, you can lower this option to a frame rate you like. The max UI frame rate can be slightly lower. 90 is what was automatically selected for me, and I have no issues with it. The graphics setting portion will help optimize how Aimlab runs. I maximize this by putting graphics quality to the fastest and turning every remaining option off. Some important ones to note are muzzle flash, which is a visible light after each round is shot, shell casing, which will toss a shell out of the gun for each round and target destruction, which has a shattering effect that can be distracting and also requires more effort from your PC. Visuals is where you can adjust the background. However, I use the standard single color preset with tiling set to 1. This is the size of the grid. I also recommend turning reflections and smoothness to 0 as it will reduce the load on your computer and make the image more crisp. Controls are your sensitivity settings, and the Aimlab game settings at the top is quite helpful for pulling in-game sensitivity into Aimlab, so try this first. If this seems off, I recommend using the hipfire subheadings, and unfortunately the best way I found to convert sensitivity as accurately as possible is measuring the distance your mouse moves on your mousepad in a 360 turn in your game of choice with a ruler, and then changing the mouse sensitivity horizontal setting until the 360 in Aimlab measures the same distance. I use 90 FOV as my main game is Siege. For games, the countdown duration can be altered from the default 5, which is quite a while to wait before every run. I use 3 seconds, but you should test around and see what is comfortable for you. I highly recommend changing the setting. In cosmetics, you can change the target coloring and finishes with metallic and smoothness. However, I keep both at 0. Gameplay settings is the last subheading, and I recommend changing weapon visibility to hide. This removes the hand and gun, removing obstructions. Also, turn recoil and sway off. Lastly, we have keybinding. I have only ever changed keybinds a few times, and this was because very rarely I would hit keys on my keyboard or side buttons on old mice that had effects in-game. Then I found the key and unbound it, so if I accidentally pressed them, nothing would happen. you realistically will not need to alter keybinds. That's all for this video. If you like this style of content and want to see more, don't forget to like and subscribe, and leave a question or recommendation for the next video.